The following is a Benjamin Faust special presentation brought to you by Procter & Gamble.
The issue being that I admire YouTube, but I have to say when you're this big, it causes distortions. The Herfindahl-Hirschman Index, or HHI, referred affectionately by one of my favorite students as the Her-Hir Index. Try that with me real quick. Just flip your tongue back and go Her-Hir, Her-Hir. Very good. This measures market concentration, and it does it brilliantly by a simple mathematical computation that even the entry level of students can do with just basic math. Up here real quick, I have the four major competitive environments that businesses can find themselves in. You start at the perfect competition, which has many competitors and is very consumer friendly. And then as we move over towards monopoly, there are fewer competitors. Monopoly in essence is just one competitor, one seller in the market, and it's not so consumer friendly. Governments are quite aware of this and they take steps to make sure things are in check for the consumer, trying to keep the amount of competition at least somewhat fair so it does not become too concentrated where the sellers have more and more power to control the market. You might be thinking, what would be so hard about this? Let's just see who controls the market, find out the percentage they control, and then list it. The problem with that is, as you move from perfect competition closer and closer to monopoly, you get to the point where there's an outsized effect of control that the businesses have on the market. To illustrate this, I have a list that includes YouTube and its close competitors. Now, if you do a search on the internet to find out YouTube's market share, you're gonna get varying answers. But if you think about it, YouTube provides quite a specific service in a specific way. And for many consumers and content providers, it feels to many of them like it's the only real choice. So I settled on some data coming in from the company Datenize, which is measuring their share of the market by the number of websites that use their tools. So although it's not a perfect correlation to their actual market share, I think it's a good proxy to work with for purposes of our activity. Let's first run through this market and look at it without applying the HHI, and then we'll go through, apply the HHI, and do it again so you can kind of see the effect that the HHI has on presenting this kind of data and what it tells us about the market. All right, here I have YouTube and the close competitors of YouTube, as well as their market share percentage as done by proxy as I described earlier. Now let's say we wanted to take this data and show how concentrated the market is. We could look at YouTube's number being 74 and say, well, that's pretty high. And maybe if we set perfect competition at something like 0 and then monopoly at 100, because it has 100% of the market, this market might fall somewhere in here at about 74. But is that the total picture? What about Vimeo, which is a second place, distant second, but they still control 20% of the market? We really didn't account for that by just taking the largest competitor. What about a situation where you only have three competitors and they all have between 30 and 40% of the market? These problems I'm describing are what make the HHI such a great tool to use. I'm gonna put some math on the board. Do not be afraid. I will explain it. We will go through it together. If you've had a certain level of math, this may make sense to you. All we're gonna be doing is taking each market share and squaring it, multiplying itself by itself, and then adding them all together, from the largest competitor all the way to the smallest competitor. Let's start off with a super easy one. All the other competitors in the market. One, we gotta square it. So on your calculator, 1 to the second power, or you can just type 1 times 1. Super easy, right? What about Bright Cove and Flow Player? Both 1 also. What about JW Player and Wistia? Both have a 2% share. 2 times 2 is 4, so they both get, you called it. Vimeo is where it gets a little bit more complicated. 19 times 19. Vimeo's where the calculator really does come in handy. And the big one, YouTube. Yeah, I seem to have got some marker on myself. Occupational hazard. Excellent, so we have our squares done for all of the market percentages. Quick tip, if the market percentages are given to you in a decimal form out of 1 instead of out of 100, you must move the decimal point to the right 2 places or multiply by 100 first to make sure it works. If you do not do this, you will get the wrong answer. So according to our formula here, we're going to take each competitor, square their market share percentage, and then add them all together. That's what this Greek letter sigma, capital sigma, means. It means we're going to take a summation of everything. So all we have to do now is add all those squares together, sum of the squares. You should have gotten 5,848. Let's go ahead and interpret that meaning. Back on our chart where we have perfect competition and monopoly at our two extremes. What if we calculated the HHI for just a monopoly, for a competitor that has 100% of the market share? What would we get? If you said 10,000, you are correct. On the other extreme, what if we are approaching perfect competition? Let's be very generous here, because a perfect competition is a bit like a magical fuzzy unicorn. It may not exist in real life. So let's be generous here and say it's less than 100. So as you're getting the picture here, if the number is low, you're likely to have a situation where it's more consumer friendly and the competitors do not have power to kind of control and manipulate the market. However, if the number is high, you're looking at a situation where it's likely damaging to the consumer. So we've got our number, 5848. Let's go ahead and interpret that Her-Hir number, that HHI number, Her-Hir. So although we said in a perfect competition environment, it would be less than 100, here's what you would be looking at if you're maybe a government regulator. Less than 1500 is gonna be regarded as a normal competitive market. If you're between 1500 and 2500, moderate concentration in the market. And here's the danger zone. Let me get my angry red pen out. Above 2500 on the HHI will be a highly concentrated market that, depending on other factors and depending on the regulations in that particular country, it may be something where the government needs to take action. So where does that put YouTube? Again, using our proxy for their market share based on the websites that use their system to present videos, they have a 74% market share with one large competitor, several small competitors, and they have an HHI of over 5,000, which makes them in the danger category with a greater than 2,500 concentration with the HHI. Which makes a lot of sense to me, because I got an interesting email the other day. Now, don't get me wrong, I like YouTube. I enjoy making videos for YouTube, and especially since the pandemic, I've used it for work. It's been an invaluable tool to help reach my students and present information. That being said, the other day, I got a change of terms of service. YouTube, as you know, is basically a media company that sells advertising in order to make a profit. And since they have gone mainstream, they like to kind of vet the channels and the videos that they're ads are going to appear on, because certain brands don't want to be next to controversial content. And since that takes some manpower, they restrict that to channels that are larger. Smaller channels have to build up to the point at which they are large enough to get that kind of screening from YouTube, or they have to simply not have ads and wait. That'll change with this email from YouTube. I'm not going to get it out and read it to you, but basically it was, if your channel is smaller, we still might run ads on it. Let me translate that for you. That means we now have technology that makes it more efficient for us to find videos that are profitable and acceptable for our advertisers in order to make more money, but we're not going to share it with you. And quite frankly, that's the kind of stuff that the HHI tells us. They are, for many of us, like I said kind of in my teaser intro, they're the only people who do what they do in the way that they do that have people there to watch. And so when YouTube wants to make a change in terms that upsets smaller channels, they can and will, because I'm telling you right now, they're too big. I've invested too much time in them. I have so many videos, both private and public, on there that I'm not about to migrate to another platform. They have a tremendous amount of power in the market, especially when it comes to their content creators. And of course, my channel is smaller, and it upset me a little bit. But I always had in the back of my head that even though I'm smaller, at least there won't be ads for my students or other people on there, since I am smaller. But since that's all changing, I have to tell you, being who I am, I went through my contacts, made a few phone calls to Cincinnati, Ohio, and got myself a sponsorship. That way I kind of get ahead of this terms of service thing for YouTube, right? So of course, I want to endorse Dawn dish detergent from Procter & Gamble. This stuff is great. I use it to clean my glasses. I use it to clean my dishes when I don't feel like doing the dishes in the dishwasher. I even use it to make bubble bath in my bathtub, but I would not recommend getting any water in your eyes if you're gonna do that, just an aside there. And you know, I was a vegetarian full on for 3 years, and so I'm into some natural stuff and some natural remedies. And if you'll notice here, they have ducks on their label, and I just love that they have ducks because it's homeopathic. You see, Dawn is great about cutting through grease when you are washing the dishes. If you have a really messy dish or a really messy pan, great at cutting through the grease, and that's because ducks are very oily birds. And so what they do, sorry to say for the ducks, they grind them up, and the little particles of ducks are in Dawn dish detergent. It's homeopathic. Everybody wins. So make sure next time you're at the supermarket or your favorite discount store or even ordering online that you look for the name Dawn. Don't go for imitations. If your dish messes have you feeling unlucky, look for the ducky.